I pick it up where I left off. And this is a couple of months a couple of weeks ago I spoke about what comes next. And honestly, I don't know. Because in thinking about what happened in 2019 and just the fact that I still don't I still don't always handle everything properly. I've said it that if I did this or if I did that, then, things would be different. But the fact of the matter is, nobody knows that. You don't know if one decision is what made you, what brought you to the position that you're in, or what put you in the place that you're in. You don't know that. Nothing gives you that, ability to know that. But I know that looking back at 2019 and looking back at how I was at my in that position, one decision I should have made was I should have moved on from the job I had at that time. And I shouldn't have kept it for the better part of the next 2 years, or year and a half at least, because I think that is the reason why I stayed unemployed for 7 months, looking for the right job, looking for something new, getting to the point mentally where I felt like I could be back in a place of work and not be overly angry and not be overly aggressive and not have a temperamental attitude like I did at my old job. And it took me a long time. Because mentally, I was in a haze. And the reason why working with Hashtag Hope was so important to me last year was because, much like the reason why I worked with Stack Up this year is, it's real life. And I know I've been at this game, this social media game, this content creation game for a long time. And, Twitch changed everything. Literally changed everything. We have the, I'm a documentarian. And the fact of the matter is, had I left my previous job, I may not have met the friend, I may not have made friends with the friend that put me onto the platform, which then directed me to streaming and to get more actively involved in this content creation game. I know, again, you don't know if one decision could have changed everything, but how would I have gotten into a different position? How would I have learned more about this profession, this glorious, glorious profession, had that one friend not told me just to do it? How would that have been the case if I was not told that one day in September to just go for it? What do you have to lose? And that changed everything. Maybe I would have still found my way to streaming. Maybe I still would have found my way to increasing my consistency on the on this platform, and maybe I would have still found my way to content creation, but the fact of the matter is, there is no guarantee that that would have been the case. Because I used to credit that one friend for everything. For directing me to the platform, for and I always tried to be perfect for that one friend. But in turn, that caused me to be somebody I'm not. I'm not perfect. And I should have never tried to be. Because that put an unfair amount of pressure on myself, and in turn, put an unfair amount of pressure on the relationship with that friend. As I said, I ruined plenty of relationships. Because I would split from someone and I would give somebody a reason to leave before they would find it. And it wasn't a self-esteem issue. It was the thought of there's no reason why they should. You know, and the fact of the matter is, the one saying I hate is, why didn't you come to me sooner? And I know that saying, I know that saying that I didn't want to because I didn't feel like it. I didn't want to talk about it. I know that's a cop-out. But death does not deserve you. You deserve you. And that's something that I had to learn. You know, and the fact of the matter is, now I can sit here and say that it isn't a cop-out. It's the fact that you tell those people that want, that you tell those people that were worried, you tell those people that wondered why you didn't say something sooner. You tell them that you're okay now. That when you look in the darkness, you see people waving light. Because that's what I see. And that's what I know. But at the hardest time, the light isn't. You don't see it. Because sometimes it gets too dark. Sometimes you get too blind to your. You get too blind. That you can't see. And it's not that you get too blind that you can't see a way out, it's that you can't see anything. And you just accept that this is how things are. But it doesn't have to be how things are. It doesn't have to be how things are. It's how you make them out to be. You know, and I'm not going to say that I'm blaming. I'm speaking from experience. Because that's exactly what I do. And there are many days where I wish I. There are many days when I wish I was. Where I wish I could go back. Where I wish I didn't make the mistakes that blew up the relationships. And where those people that used to be in my life, that would have stayed had I gave them the option, instead of taking it away, that would have given me the help I needed had I asked for, or could have. I have a bad relationship with my past. Because the fact of the matter is, I don't know if I will ever not be chased by my demons. It's just now I have people to help me carry the weight. I just don't know what weight to give them, because I don't know what weight they'd want. Because it's been my weight for the longest time, and I don't know how to share it. And I still push people away by the one tried and true way of doing that. The one way I know how to do it. And the one way I know how to do that is by being too nice. By trying to be too good. Instead of acting normal. Instead of instead of picking on somebody, making a joke, instead of always going the serious route, always checking on somebody, always being the one to check on somebody, never expecting somebody to go check on you. And it's not always trying to guilt trip, always trying to do this, always trying to do that. No. I say it because I don't expect it, because I don't want it. Nobody wants these demons, but these demons. You know, as a wise man once said, these demons are a cruel bitch. And it requires a daily fight. I've tried being perfect and I'm tired of it. I'm tired of trying to be somebody I'm not. And I wish I could just be who I am. But I'm not. And I try to be, but it's also, it's also the fact that when you look at it from a perspective, when you look at it from, like, when you look at it from, you know, there's different ways to put it. There's different ways to say it. And the fact is, there are days when I sit here, and I have friends on stream that would greet me with open arms and a willingness to talk and, you know, open DMs, and everybody I know would say that. And the fact of the matter is, there are just days where I don't want it. When I just want to sit here and not talk about nothing. And just not be social. And then I sit here and wonder why, you know, this person over here has such a good relationship with these guys if they never, you know, if they never talk and blah, 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 or why these guys are always in Discord together and, you know, this, that, and the other thing. And the fact of the matter is, it's because when I'm on my own, doing my own thing, sitting in my room, sitting at my PC, wallowing in my own self-pity and thinking that there's got to be more to life, and instead of making the steps, taking the steps and making something happen and doing something, I'm just sitting here doing nothing. And the fact of the matter is, the amount of times I've heard, you're almost 30. You gotta figure out what you wanna do with your life. You gotta figure out something. You can't live at home all your life. What are you gonna do? Now's when you should make a move. You gotta strive for your potential. You gotta do something more. You know, you gotta go into management now. You can't just stay in the same field. You know, you can't just keep working part-time. You can't do this, you can't do that. How about somebody tells me something I can do instead of continuously telling me something I can't? The one thing that I do on a daily basis that I have control over is this. And that's why at 3 o'clock in the morning, I am sitting here doing this journal entry, doing this appeal, doing this. Because it's the only thing I have control over. It's the only way I can tell. I can say what's on my mind and not have anybody tell me I'm wrong. The amount of times that I've thought about giving up on this, the amount of times I've thought about just being... being normal. But the fact of the matter is, what the hell is normal? What the hell is that anyway? What the hell is normal? Is normal something you can be anymore? Or is there so many different definitions of what normal is that there is actually not one clear-cut definition of normal? Or is that how it's always been and I'm just delusional to think that there was one set definition of the word? Because society wants you to think that there is one set definition. That if you're not married with kids and a high-paying job with a house by a certain age, then there's something wrong with you. If you're not seeing somebody in a relationship by a certain age, then there's something wrong with you. If you don't have your life figured out by a certain age, then there's something wrong with you. Well, believe you me, I realized a long time ago that there is something wrong with me, but the fact of the matter is, I'm getting to the point where I'm learning to accept it. Because I saw what happened when I hid from it. You know, and I have been told more than once, when I was actually told to speak about it, when I was actually forced to speak about it because of the stream with #hope last year. And it's something I probably should speak about a bit more often. I myself have had ideations. But I've never done it. I've never done anything. I've spoken to the suicide prevention hotline. And they've helped. 988 does help. It does. But I've also learned that when you need somebody 90% of the time, If you look, you will find someone. You just got to. You know, it was my experience recently that I may not have made a clear enough attempt to make people, to give people in my community the opportunity to understand that genuinely, if they ever need anything, my DMs are open. You know, I'd much rather talk to you guys. And I know that sounds hypocritical. And the reason why that sounds hypocritical is because 90% of the time, because 90% of the time, if I'm having an episode, I just let it pass. I just let it pass. Especially if a couple of days ago I went to somebody and asked them for help. Especially if that's the case. Because I don't want to go to them more than once. I don't want to bother them. I don't want to bring them into that and show them how messed up I am. And the the truth. And I know that there's probably reasons. And I know maybe if I did something different back into, you know, back before I had the breakdown, things would have been different. If I would have went to my manager and told him, if I would have went to my parents, if I would have went to a family member, a friend, someone, things would have been different. I know that now. But the fact of the matter is, I did not think that then. Because the fact is, when I was growing up, mental health was not something that a lot of people spoke about. It was not an open-ended thing. You know, it was not something that people considered worth talking about. Because the fact of the matter is, mental health was something you kept in, and when people found out that there was something wrong, it wasn't until after the fact. Now there is still a stigma, but it's a lot more open-ended than it used to be. But people still don't want to talk about it. I know, because I'm one of them. I know because I still choose not to. Even when I should. And it pisses me off. And I know it pisses off people that care about me. I know it does. Because I've been told exactly that. You know what I mean? That's all I gotta say. I'm still learning. There is no end point. And I know it's frustrating. I know it is. Believe me. But there is a way to find a support system. There are tools out there. Now, didn't exist when people needed them. And you don't know how much those people would have benefited from those tools. But the first way to get to the point where you want to is accepting that something's wrong and learning how to fix it, learning how to control it. I know that was the toughest thing for me to do. It still is. See you guys soon.